Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add a Blazor Barcode Generator component to a Blazor WebAssembly application. With the barcode generator, you can create machine-readable optical labels that contain information about the item they are attached to. The information may be a location, a URL, an address book, etc. Let's see how to configure a few barcode types, QR codes and data matrices, and explore customizations like dimensions, colors, and fonts. I will also show you how to export the generated barcode as an image. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019 or 2022, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2022. Make sure that you have installed a compatible SDK version like the .NET Core SDK 3.1.8, .NET 5.0 SDK, or .NET 6.0 SDK. First, I open Visual Studio 2022 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Then, I choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Next button. I name my project and click Next. Then, I select .NET 6.0 as the target framework and click the Create button. A project has been created and is ready to use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the barcode generator component to this project. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor barcode generator package. I open the NuGet package manager, search for the Syncfusion Blazor barcode generator package, and install it in my application. Once installed, you can see the package is added to this application's packages folder. Then, I navigate to the imports.razor page and import the syncfusion.blazor.barcodegenerator namespace. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, I import the syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @syncfusionblazor method. Set the ignore script isolation option to true to improve application performance by referencing the script externally. I also need to register the license with a valid key using the register license method to avoid the license validation message. Next, I navigate to the index.html page within the root folder and include the script reference as I have enabled the ignore script isolation option. Then I add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 5 CSS reference from the installed package. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can check out the video linked in the card above. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor barcode generator component to the index.razor page. Include the SF barcode generator tag. To visualize the barcode, I will include the value property and set its value to Syncfusion. Let me run this application to generate the barcode. See the output. The barcode is rendered with the value provided. Next, I will show you how to use the built-in content types, code 3.9, code 3.9 extended, code 11, code 3.2, and others. You can check the types on the website linked in the card above. Here I will include the type property and set its value to code 39 to support numbers 0 to 9, uppercase letters, and spaces. Looking at the output, the barcode is not rendered because I provided a value with lowercase characters. Here, I change the value with appropriate code 39 content. Now the barcode is rendered with uppercase and numeric values. Next, I will show you how to customize the barcode dimension. I will include the height property with a value of 100 pixels and include the width property with a value of 200 pixels. The output barcode is rendered with the dimension specified. Next, I will show you how to customize the barcode color and text. To customize the color, I will include the for color property and set its value to red. Now the barcode color is changed to red. To customize the text, I will include the barcode generator display text property with the text code 39 barcode. Check out the barcode's displayed text. Now I will show you how to generate a QR code and a data matrix. Include the SF QR code generator tag. All the properties in the barcode are applicable to the QR code except the type property. Let's copy and paste the height, width, and four color properties and their values. Here is the rendered QR code. If you want to customize the text, include the QR code generator display text tag and set the text to Syncfusion. Check now, the QR code text is customized. Similarly, include SF data matrix generator and set the height, width, and value properties. See the output data matrix is rendered. Finally, I will show you how to export the barcode as an image. I will use the Syncfusion button and click it to export the barcode. I have already installed the Syncfusion Blazor buttons package. Import the button's namespace and include the SF button tag. Then include the value export. Add the onClick event and assign the callback method on export. To access the built-in methods of the barcode generator, I add the @ref property and assign the barcode instance. In the onExport method, using the barcode instance, call the built-in method export with a file name and image type as arguments. Here I specify the file name Syncfusion image and the barcode export type JPG. When I click this button, the barcode will be exported as an image. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application, add a barcode generator component to it, and configure a few of the barcode's basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also included a link in the description where you can see if you're eligible for our community license to get a free license key to use our Blazor products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.